Hello, Dr. here. In this video, we are going to solve a very common VLOOKUP related problem. Let's look at the data first. I have two columns, country ID and product ID. I want the country name and product name. I have those in a separate file, country ID country and product name along with the product price. In order to combine this, obviously, I'll have to put VLOOKUP, and I'm going to do a lot of VLOOKUP. Every row will be a VLOOKUP here as well as for product. And in order to get the total price, I have to combine quantity with the unit price, which is another VLOOKUP. So what is the problem here? As the number of VLOOKUPs increase, the performance will go down, file size will go up, your overheads will increase. And remember, all these files which are coming are probably on OneDrive, Teams or SharePoint. Now, if one of those files was closed, this becomes HTTP address. Many times people don't even know where the files are linked. So if you go to edit links, many people don't even check the status every time. You should, because sometimes the file is not available. Sometimes the path has changed and you have no idea that this is not getting updated. So it's all chaotic and dangerous. There are two solutions. One is I could import these three tables separately into a data model, create relationships between them, and then manage the show. I've already created a video for that. Have a look at it. There are two problems with the data model approach. One, I'm still importing all the raw data into Excel and data model is managing the relationship live, which is still an overhead. The second part is the data and the relationships are combined with each other in data model. I don't see them in Excel sheets, and many of us, we want the raw data in Excel sheet so that we can do additional formulas, sort, filter, conditional formatting, whatever else you want. Once the data goes into data model, you're not going to see it in Excel. So what's the solution? Use Power Query. Why Power Query? Because all these calculations, relationships, all these are not going to change unless the raw data changes. Who is importing the raw data? Who is cleaning up the raw data? Power Query. So might as well do this if we look up equivalent calculations in Power Query itself. So let's see how that is done. Create a blank new file and we will import these into Power Query. So data. Get data from file Excel. I'm going to use the transaction file first. I'm going to choose this and choose transform data. Now I got the transaction table in. Similarly, I want the other two tables. I don't have to go outside Power Query. I can say new source file, Excel workbook, choose the country, add it. So I get country table here. And similar thing I'll do for the product table. Now what are we trying to do? In transaction, the country ID, something like VLOOKUP we want to do and match it with this country ID and get the name of the country. Now in Power Query, there is no VLOOKUP, but the equivalent of VLOOKUP in Power Query is called merge queries. Now these are three separate tables. Let's leave them alone. We are going to merge queries, but as a new query. So first is the transaction table. Let's combine it with countries. In VLOOKUP, I would have put this as the first parameter. I just choose the country ID column and the equivalent column on the other side. Everything matches, click OK. Now the entire countries table is coming. I don't want that. So I click on this expand button and I say I only want the country column and I don't want any prefixes. So I got the country. This is equivalent of VLOOKUP. We also want to do the same thing for products. Now this is already a separate table. So in this case, I'm going to say merge query. So whatever merging happens will happen in this table itself. On the other side, we will choose the products table, match the product ID, and then when you are expanding, in this case, I want two things. I want the product name as well as the unit price. The only thing we want now is the price, which is unit price multiplied by quantity. So let's add a column, custom column, and let's say price, and simply do the calculation here. Quantity, double click, multiplied by unit price. Now we are almost there, but just look at the data and see. Are there any columns which are not really required when we finally import the clean data? So country ID, product ID were just interim, so we just don't need them. If you want, you can keep the quantity, but unit price has already done its job by multiplying it. So remove it. And because this is a new column we added, the data type is still any. So you know this is a number. So change it to number. Make sure all the data types are correct. And now it's time to load. Never click on close and load. Always click on close and load too. We are going to choose only connection. So finally, when I close and load, it's going to just create four connections. Why did I choose? If I had chosen table, then all four tables would have got imported. So to start with, we have chosen only create connection. But now this is the final table. This has everything I want exactly the way pre-calculated, no VLOOKUP. I want this table. Now the question is, where do you want to load? If you want it in Excel and you want to do some ad hoc work, sort, filter, conditional formatting, charts, formulas of your own, just import it as a raw data. Click on this and it's done. Imagine how much time, energy, overheads, file size you have saved by eliminating VLOOKUP completely. If you're new to data model, you must watch my data model masterclass video. That will help you a lot in handling not just VLOOKUP elimination, but also large, slow Excel files. So that's it for now. Thank you.